Happy morning, children. In this session, you will be learning about co-prime numbers, twin prime numbers, and prime triplet numbers. You have been exposed to this, but some of the students have some doubts on that, so I am just revising it. Co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers is always a pair. When you take only two numbers, you can talk about co-prime. If there are three numbers or more numbers, you cannot talk about co-prime. Co-prime means it's always about a pair. So, what is a co-prime pair? Co-prime pair, it's basically a pair of numbers which have only one as a common factor. Okay? And they have no other factors than one. Two numbers forming a pair such that they have no other common factor other than one is called a co-prime pair or co-prime numbers. Examples 2 and 3, 3 and 5, 7 and 8 are co-prime pairs. See, if you see that 7 is a prime number, 8 is a prime composite number. But when 7 and 8 taken together, though both are not prime numbers, they yet form a pair, co-prime pair, because 7 and 8 both are divisible by 1 only. Okay, but there is no other number than 1 which divides both 7 and 8. And here 2 and 3 both are prime numbers. So any two prime numbers always form a co-prime. Here also 3 and 5 both are prime numbers. Any two numbers always form a co-prime pair. So, note first is, two prime numbers always form a co-prime pair. Example, 3 and 7 both are prime numbers. Therefore, 3 comma 7 form a co-prime. 23 and 9, again another pair of co-prime numbers, pairs. Number 2, in a co-prime pair, both the numbers need not be prime. See, 3 and 4 are two numbers and 4 is a composite number and 3 is a prime number. Therefore, 3 and 4, one prime and composite number, they form a co-prime because the common divisor for 3 and 1 is 1 only. Both the numbers are divisible by 1 only, and no other number than 1 will divide 3 and 4 both. Similarly, 8 and 9. 8 is a composite number and 9 is a prime number. But 8 and 9, this pair is a co-prime pair because only 1 will divide 8 and 9 both. And it's a co-prime pair. Third, in a co-prime pair, both the numbers may be composite. Both the numbers, see, in the case of 9 is a composite number, 3, 3 is a 9, 14 is a even number and so composite number. But when you take the pair 9 comma 14, both the numbers are, I mean, the pair is a co-prime pair because only one will divide both. No other number will divide both 9 and 14. Similarly, in the case of 35 comma 39, this is also a co-prime pair. 39 is a composite number divisible by 3. Okay, and 35 is a composite number divisible by 7 and 5. But the pair 35 comma 39 is a co-prime pair. So the fourth one is, two consecutive numbers always form a co-prime pair. If we take two consecutive numbers 3, 4, next comes 7, 8, 10, 11. This will always form a co-prime pair. Okay. And then twin primes. The twin prime numbers, it is again a pair, twin prime. Twin means two. So two numbers are there. So it is a pair only. A pair basically. And both the numbers are prime. You cannot have a combination of prime and composite or composite and prime. Both the numbers should be prime numbers. Such form prime numbers with a common difference of 2 between them. The difference between the two numbers, two prime numbers, would be 2. So such a prime pair is called a twin prime pair. Example 3 and 5. 3 and 5 are both are prime, and the difference between them is 2. So this is a twin prime. 5, 7. Difference is 2. 5 and 7 both are prime numbers. Similarly, 17 and 19. Okay. And 11 and 13. These are all twin primes. Okay. Third, prime triplet. Triplet means three numbers. So here we are not having talking about four. You will be in the context of three numbers. You are talking about whether there are prime triplet or not. What does it mean actually? A set of three different prime numbers that differ by two consecutively, that differ by two consecutively when written in ascending or descending order is called prime triplet. Okay. Set of three numbers. You will have to have three numbers such that when they are written in ascending order and the consecutive difference between them, the common difference between them, when you take the numbers pairwise consecutively, the difference would be 2. So one example is given here, 3, 5, 7. The difference, they are written in ascending order. So the difference between the consecutive numbers 3 and 5 is 2. And similarly, the difference between 5 and 7 is 2. But you cannot take into account 3 and 7, the difference is 4, because 3 and 7 are not consecutive. They are, when written in ascending order, this would be consecutive. Okay. So note that 5, 7, 9, 17, 19, 29. See here, even again some triplet, 5, 7, 9. Okay. They are differing by 2. When written in ascending order, the difference between 5 and 7 is 2, and the difference between 7 and 9 is 2. But they are not all prime numbers. 9 is a composite number. This is not a prime triplet. Similarly, 17, 19, 21 is again not a prime triplet, as 21 is a composite number. So all the three numbers would be prime, and when written in ascending or descending order, the prime, the difference between them should be 2. This is the main condition for a prime triplet number. Now note, we are using these concepts, concepts and observations in LCM. Okay, so where do we use it? See, the LCM of coprime pair is the product. See, you are asked to find the LCM of two numbers, a pair, and you see, you observe that the two numbers form a coprime pair. So in that case, simply multiply the two numbers, the product will give you the LCM. You need not go by the prime factorization method for finding the LCM of such pairs. So the LCM of coprime pairs is the product. LCM of twin prime, again, you two prime numbers are given, twin prime, okay, 7, 9 or 9, 11, their product is the, is their LCM. So in that case also you can say, you can generalize it all. Two consecutive numbers form a coprime, and so the LCM of the consecutive numbers is the product. Two consecutive numbers are coming means they form a coprime. Then also the product is this one. And you know, if a pair of numbers are such that either is the factor of the other or the multiple of the other, then the bigger number is their LCM. Okay. Therefore, this is it. Two prime numbers are given. Both the numbers are prime. In that case also, the LCM is their product. It need not be twin prime. The condition second I have said, twin prime. So it is applicable for all prime numbers. Two prime numbers are given, then they form a coprime. Okay. So then also the product is the LCM. So these notings are invariably used in LCM. Okay. So now we will go to the case of three or more numbers. Sometimes if we have been doing on working with only two numbers, finding the LCM of two numbers only. Now we are having three or more numbers. Okay. In that case, what should be? How will we find the LCM? So it is very simple. Find the LCM of 40, 80, 120, 160. We have taken four numbers. We want to find the LCM of this. Just by seeing this, we can work it out. See, what is the LCM of 40 and 80? It is 80, because 40 is the factor of 80 and 80 is the multiple of factor. In that case, the bigger number for these two is 80. Okay? And then you take all the three numbers, 40, 80 and 120. In this case, 120 is the multiple of 40. Okay? So in that case, 120 and 40 also can be combined and you can find their LCM as 120. And 80 and 160, if you take 80 and 160, they are multiple and factor relation. 80 is the factor of 160 and 160 is the multiple of 80. So for 80 and 160, you can take 160 as LCM. For 40 and 120, you can take 120 as the LCM. Therefore, instead of finding the LCM of all four, we can take 120 and 160 and find their LCM, to find the LCM of all the four numbers. Okay, so that is one way of doing it. It will be shorter, but we will do it methodically so that you do not commit any mistake in doing the problem. Okay, so you know that prime factorization method, you will have this kind of a structure. You will be writing down all the four numbers as dividends with separated with commas. Okay, first you see all the numbers are you will be trying with the prime factorization, prime number you will have to write. So first you will be doing like this. 2 divides all these numbers. So you will put 2 here. After putting 2, divide all the numbers and you will get 40 divided by 2 gives 20. 80 divided by 2 gives 40. 120 divided by 2 gives 60. 160 divided by 2 gives 80. So that is written here. Again you see that all the 4 numbers are divisible by 2. So you will divide it by 2. 20 divided by 2 gives 10, 40 divided by 2 gives 20, 60 divided by 2 gives 30, 80 divided by 2 gives 40. So that is written here. Again you see that all the 4 numbers are divisible by 2. So you divide it by 2. And 10 divided by 2 gives 5, 20 divided by 2 gives 10, 30 divided by 2 gives 15, 40 divided by 2 gives 20. And then again you see here 2 is no longer dividing all the 4 numbers. But you see, 5 divides all the 4 numbers. So you will put 5 here. Then try with 5. 5 divided by 5 gives 1. And 10 divided by 5 gives 2. 15 divided by 5 gives 3. 20 divided by 5 gives 4. So this way I have written it. Now you see, if you think of 2 and 3, it is a co-prime pair. Now you will have to see whether they are co-prime or not. Okay. No number will divide all the 4 numbers. No number other than 1 will divide all the 4 numbers. Okay. So you just take in pairs 1 to form a, you cannot 1, 2, it is a co-prime because 1 only will divide both. And 2, 3, it is divisible. But when you take 2 and 4, okay, you need not take consecutively. You can take the second and fourth number also. 2 and 4 is not co-prime. So you will have to check whether any type of pair formed out of this 4, okay, is not a co-prime. So you will check here. Yeah, are these numbers pairwise co-prime? You just ask this question. No, when you take the pair 2 and 4, it is not co-prime. So what you will do, you will be just taking 2 here, which divides both 2 and 4. The common factor for 2 and 4 is 2. So you will just, when 1 is not divisible by 2, so you will simply put 1 here. 2 divided by 2 gives 1. 3 is not divisible by 2, so you will simply drop down 3. And 2 and 4, when you take 4 is divisible by 3, 2 2 is 4. So you will write like this. Whichever number is not divisible by 2, that will be dropped down as it is. And whichever pair, this 2 and 4 are divisible by 2, they are written like this. Now you again ask the question, are all these 4 numbers pairwise co-prime? You can form any pair, 1, 1, okay, 1, 3 co-pair, 3, 2 is also co-pair. Any pair you form out of these 4 numbers, all the pairs are co-prime. Okay, are these numbers pairwise co-prime? Yes, all these pairwise, all are co-prime. So you can stop here saying that the above 4 numbers are pairwise co-prime. You have checked it, you need not go by this. So after that, you will be writing down all these red colored factors on the devices. Okay. And then the last left out remained quotients 3 and 2. You need not write the
quotient 1 and 1, because 1 multiply, it is, they are insignificant factors. So you can just find LCM of 48 is equal to these red numbers into 3 and 2, these green colored quotients. Okay. So when you multiply all this, you will get the LCM. That's what it is. 2 to the 4, the rest of the factors written as it is. In the next step, 2 4 jar 8, the rest of the factors as it is. 4 8 5 jar 40, I'm taking pairwise from the left and then simplifying step by step. When you do like this, at the end you will get, it is 480. 480 is the LCM of this. In your book, it is solved this way. They have done as it is, as we have done. Okay. And after that, in this step, they are saying, you just divide it by 2. The first number which is not 1. So when you divide it by 2, you will be dropping 1 is not divisible by 2. So you will drop down as it is. 3 is not divisible by 2. So you will drop down as it is. But 2 is divisible by 2, which is 1 quotient. And 4 is divisible by 2, quotient is 2. So it's again, you will be writing like this. The next non-unit number is 3. So you will be dividing by 3. Okay. So here also 2 not divisible by 2 means you will drop it as it is. And 2. This way you will be doing it until all the quotients become 1. You will be writing it. You can multiply all the left hand side these numbers. See that this prime factorization and this prime factorization both are same. So you can either follow this method, or as it is said in your book, you can follow this method to find the LCM. There are some people may be writing like this. They immediately say, sir, 10 is a common multiple of all the 4 numbers. Instead of writing the common prime number here, can we take out the common factor and do it? Yes, very well, you can do like that. So take 10, you can write it as 40 divided by 10 is 4, 80 divided by 10 is 8, 120 divided by 10 is 12, 160 divided by 10 is 16. So common factor of 10 is very obviously striking. So take it out and do it, nothing wrong in that. You'll actually, in fact, you need not write it as prime factorization only. You can put some common factor here, which may be a composite number also. So next, the quotients 4, 8, 12, 16, these are again having a common factor 4, all are divisible by 4. So you can put a common factor 4 here and divide them accordingly. 4 1 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 4 3 jar 12, 4 4 jar 16. So it will come something like this. Now again, you see here, are all these having a common co-prime pairwise? No. 2 and 4 is a not co-prime. So for that you will put the common factor 2. Again, drop down like this. Now you see all the 4 numbers, when you form some pairs, no pair will be co-prime. So simply you leave it here saying that the above 4 numbers are pairwise co-prime, and then you multiply 10 into 4 into 2 and then 3 into 2. This way also you will get 480. So all the methods are correct. The first method which I did, see 40 and 120, if you pair this, you will get 120 as the LCM. And 80 and 160, if you pair this, you will get 160 as the LCM. Therefore, 120 and 160, the LCM, if you find it out, it is going to be 480 only. You can check it by taking the LCM of 80 and 160. Sorry, 120 and 160. Okay, that's it. Then I hope you have understood this. You can apply this kind of method in the case of LCM of 3 or more numbers. Thank you, very kind of you. And kindly watch it and give a feedback also in the LMS, please. Thank you.